There is some big news that is going to be happening at the pre-screening event on the 16th of September this month in regards to, I guess, a big announcement. Now, of course, what does that mean? As someone who's going to that screening, which is going to be very fun, and I'm going to have a video on that on the day that I go to give you the insights on the first two episodes of Core 3, there's also going to be an announcement as well, and we're going to try it and sit here and guess what it is and why it may be what it is. So, with that being said, click the like and subscribe if you understood that waffle, and let's get into it, shall we? So as I just said, there's going to be a big announcement on the 16th, and of course, why is this happening? And there's a lot of speculation on what it could be, of course, on Twitter or X by some of my friends, and of course, people in the community that are saying a anime reboot, which of course is something that I highly think is not plausible considering of where we are currently within production. And I could explain more into that, but let's talk about how this kind of started in its own sense. And that is because there was a tweet a long time ago with the Bleach 20th anniversary for animation. So not the manga, but animation. Where it says, to commemorate the 20th anniversary of the TV anime, a special project that transcends the boundaries between the original work and the anime has been launched, which is interesting because this is from the animation account and this is a 20th anniversary on the anime. And of course, people are obviously going to go towards an anime reboot, which of course would make sense to some degree. And then there's something else, obviously it can't be the game, but it's interesting because if you look at it, it is a 20th anniversary for the animation, but it talks about something that transcends the anime and the original work. So this is something that could be of animation, or it could be something that transcends the anime. And what does that really mean? If there's anything I've learned within, you know, Japanese marketing, is that they overblow something to a massive proportion. Recently they did it with JJK and it was pretty much like, oh, you can read these chapters for free, and it's like it wasn't anything that spectacular. And you know, Bleach has had it many times in the past. The infamous one is the advertisement for Sakura Wars the game, but I digress. Well, and they did it with the live action when the anime finished as well. When the manga finished in 2016, they were pushing, oh, there's a big announcement. Everyone thought it was going to be the anime. No, it was a live action movie, to which was actually very, very good. But unfortunately, you know, whether it did well on Netflix, we don't really know because Netflix never really drops the numbers. But in terms of domestically in Japan, as someone that went there at the time of its opening week, big typhoon, big heat wave, people were dying. It was, you know, not the best time to have a theater release during that time, and it is what it is, right? Some people will say that I'm coping for that, but that's just my experience with it, and I wouldn't go to the cinemas in that heat or that typhoon weather just to go see a Bleach movie. So I understand to a certain degree. So what do I personally think it is? Well, let's talk about that. I don't think it's an anime reboot. And the reason why I say this is because we are in the production phase of Core 3. Obviously, no production is perfect, but Piro is in the midst of a rebrand in terms of Piro Films, right? And they're focusing currently on Core 3 and 4. Now, we know by the Bleach's anime website and domain that we have a 10-year tenure, which means that at least by the time that Core 4 is done, we're still going to have a few years of promotion left for Bleach basing off of the expiry date of the Bleach anime website, which is a good thing, I would say. Is it an anime reboot? Well, that would take a long time and an increase past its expiry date. Of course, renewals can happen, of course, naturally, but I just don't think it's a reboot because I don't think that's something like that would be considered until much later on past Core 4 or during the Core 4 process. But then again, you would think it'd be like, you know, light novel adaptations or even possibly anime movies. But is that transcending anime and the original work? Well, the original work, yeah, because of course a reboot would do it justice, right, of the original work. But it's just something, I mean, I wouldn't say no, but I just don't think it is. And then, of course, we have the game, which, again, is something that has always been expected to have. So where does that realistically leave us? The answer is I don't truly know. But recently, as today, live-action Bleach has been reported as a rumor to be coming into fruition. And I kind of dug my heels into this and said no because of some defining factors. But apparently, and you know, this person is apparently a reliable person, they mainly involve themselves within DC and Marvel leaks, and they've dabbled themselves into a random Leech League. And, you know, here's I did go onto their Patreon. I paid for it. Rest in peace, my $5, but or £5. But it says, Bleach live action, 9 hours ago, a live action American adaptation of Bleach is back in development at Warner Brothers, and they're trying to find a new writer and director for it. Now, their spelling is terrible, so I'm going to assume that they're saying, and they are trying to find a new writer and director for it, which Sato was amazing at the Bleach live action movie. I think that he did a fantastic job, great track record. The casting was great. And, you know, despite the IMDb's, I've never heard anyone actually say to me personally in Discords, in chats, in any conversations, or even in any of my videos, it's actually regarded as one of the best anime live actions out there. Like, people really praise Bleach. And again, I think the live action did a great way of diversing itself away from, you know, Bleach. The live action put itself in a position where if they wanted to do a sequel, they could. But if it flopped, it was a good standalone. And I feel like that was the purpose of changing the story slightly the way that they did. And I think it was a good decision. It was highly enjoyable. I've shown people that haven't even watched Bleach and thoroughly enjoyed it. I've showed it my parents, I've showed it my girlfriend, I've shown it my friends, and they've all enjoyed it. So, when I hear about this leak about being Warner Brothers, well, Warner Brothers do have the rights to Bleach, because obviously they were the ones that did the Bleach live action back in 2018, and maybe those rights are coming to an end, and maybe that's why they're doing a new project before they lose those rights. That's kind of like a possibility, perhaps. You know, it's not out of the ordinary. And, you know, to hear American-based is... Again, when you see things like the One Piece live action, I feel like that may be recreated here, but for Bleach. And it's plausible that it can be good. We've been seeing it with Yu Hakusho too, with Netflix. But again, Yu Hakusho was designed to just be 5 episodes and its own story. And as much as I liked it, it's not One Piece live action. And, you know, I think it really put it on the map. Now, it's not Netflix. Of course, it's not a Netflix adaptation, it's Warner Brothers. But Warner Brothers did the live action for Bleach well last time. And I do have some slight hope that they do it right this time. Unfortunately, the first time it was a Japanese live action, and now this one is American, which does like kind of tilt my head. But at the same time, the reason why I'm kind of in doubt about this is because Kubo doesn't like live actions, and the reason why he allowed the Japanese live action is because he was allowed to have his hands involved. And it's the same with Oda, right? Oda got to have his hands involved with the One Piece live action. So if Kubo is in full control of this, I support it, but it's a slippery slope. And, you know, I guess I'm just gonna have to let you guys think about that one. But if anyone at Warner Brothers wants to hit me up, ask about any opinions, I'm here. I will definitely give the best insight that I can if Mr. Kubo is not available, and do the best that I can. But other than that, if it is true, I hope they go a series route, and I hope they don't change the source material too much, because you can have a One Piece on your hands if you do it right, and don't make it cringe. You know, that's all I can say. Respect the source material, respect Kubo's his wishes, and I just hope that Shueisha and Kubo really are supervising this, if true. But again, we won't know until we see the director. We won't really know. What happened to the Naruto live action? With that being said, tell me your thoughts. Is this the big thing that's going to transcend anime and the original source material? Transcend is a big word. Transcend the original source material. Transcend, do better than the original source material. Transcend the anime. This is why I don't think this is in reference to the live action. Because it's a pretty big statement to make, considering, you know, the live actions don't really have the best of reputation. So it would be a bit of a very big oversell. And that's why I'm not personally convinced by it. But hey, if it's true, we can only see. But with that being said, I'm going to catch my focus out. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson. As always, people, peace out.